that part, like you're sitting here, can see you, but if you're sitting there, it's like, it doesn't see you.
We're listening to a lot of music by Shy Girls. I'm KEXP, just for Trivial Motion and What If I Can. Those are from the new album, Salt. Did you record Salt in your special?
Yes.
I think it is.
Did you do anything different with this album when you did your time share?
Yeah. Well, there's time share, there was a lot of guitar and everything. There was a lot of acoustic instruments on this album as well. There's a lot of guitar, there's a strong guitar, there's strings, all kinds of stuff. And also, I experimented a little bit with going to, you know, a more live studio environment, doing drums and stuff like that. Wow, there's a lot of live crash there.
And you played a lot of instruments.
Yeah, I did the drums and guitar and all that stuff, and then Kilo did most of the piano on the album.
That's nice.
And then Noah did all the wings and all the flute and sax, and I don't know what else he did. He sent me a bunch of files, and it was crazy, and I was like, this is great.
And so you have an upcoming tour, 7 Monkeys Cities. What are you looking forward to most?
Am I supposed to say Seattle? I think Portland is always special for us.
Yeah.
I mean, Portland is home. And that's always a special show. There's always friends and family and all that.
Cool. I love Portland a lot. And I really try to take a lot of time to discover music from there. The next question is, do you have any upcoming music videos for this album?
I'm working on it, but I think I'm quite finished with it.
Thank you all so much for coming on the show today. It was really nice. You just heard Glad Music by Shy Girls here on Audio Races 90.3 KEXP Seattle.
Support for KEXP in studio performances comes from contributing listeners BECU and Portage Bay Cafe. Support for KEXP comes from Washington's Lottery, helping to contribute to the well-being of communities throughout the state. Last year, $129 million helped support education. $12 million helped stadium and exhibition centers, and local retailers earned $36 million. Learn more at wowlottery.com.
Support for KEXP comes from the Sasquatch Music Festival of the Gorge, Memorial Day weekend, featuring the Shins, MGMT, Vandegrift, the OCs, and more. Full lineup and tickets on sale this Saturday at 10 a.m. at SasquatchFestival.com.
Support for local music over KEXP Seattle, the affiliate of the University of Washington, comes from the City of Seattle Office of Arts and Culture.
KEXP is seeking a great junior software developer with experience in Python, Django, and Agile Project Manager. To help us shape the next generation of experiences, KEXP listeners, qualified individuals from all cultures and communities are strongly encouraged to apply. For more information, visit kexp.org/jobs or call 206-520-5800. Audio Oasis on KEXP.
Yeah. We listened to a lot of music by Shy Girls on KEXP. Just for True Emotion and What If I Can. Those are from the new album, Salt. Did you record Salt in your special?
Yes.
In my home studio. In my bedroom.
There you go.
What
was it?
What's your most comfortable spot?
I think it is.
Did you do anything different with this album when you did your time show?
Yeah, well, there's time sure there was a lot of guitar and I think that was the acoustic instruments on the side. There's a lot of guitar, there's a strong guitar, there's strings, all kinds of stuff. And also, I experimented a little bit with going to a more live studio environment.
And you played a lot of instruments.
Yeah, I did the drums and guitar and all that stuff, and then Kilo did most of the piano on the album.
That's nice.
And then Noah did all the wings and flute and sax. I don't know what else he did. He sent me a bunch of files, and it was crazy. And I was like, this is crazy.
And so you have an upcoming tour, 7 Lucky Cities. What are you looking forward to most?
Am I supposed to say Seattle? I think Portland is always special for us.
Yeah.
I mean, Portland is home. And that's always a special show. There's always friends and family and all that.
Cool. I love Portland. And I really try to take a lot of time to discover music from you. The next question is, do you have any upcoming music videos for this album?
I'm working on it, but I haven't quite finished yet.
Well, we're glad to see you. Thank you all so much for coming on the show today. It's been nice. You just heard Glad Music by Shy Girls here on Audio Races 94.3 KEXP. Seattle.
Support for KEXP in-studio performances comes from contributing listeners BECU and Portage Bay Cafe. Support for KEXP comes from Washington's Lottery, helping to contribute to the well-being of communities throughout the state. Last year, $129 million helped support education, $12 million helped stadium and exhibition centers, and local retailers earned $36 million.
If I wasn't here, I'd be amazing. Yeah, well, no, I understand. Very true. Very true. But yeah. Anyways, good for you. Good for you doing that. That's only for you. There's obviously a reason for it. Yeah. This one for that, there's folks in the Dakota Access.
Olympia, they're called Cave Green. Pretty excited about them because they will be playing a music festival called Tree Fork that's happening in Idaho. Now, Cave Green is from Olympia. That is how I discovered them by checking out the Tree Fork lineup. And I'm going to be going out there this year to discover a bunch of bands from Idaho. Really excited to bring them back here for you. So we'll see what happens. Anyway, Kate Green will be playing on March 22nd. Super excited about that. And you've heard Peaches Green from their upcoming album, Vita Lucia. And Pleather in there with Love in Lust Cup. Baseball here on Audio Oasis. And Damien Dorado and Richard Swift covered Kraftwerk's Radioactivity here on Audio Oasis on KEXP.
Support for KEXP comes from the Seattle Boat Show, with more than 1,000 boats on display. January 27th through February 4th at CenturyLink Field at South Lake Union, with a show providing between locations. Tickets online at seattleboatshow.com.
Support for KEXP comes from Beyblade, a sex toy store run by a woman whose mission is to promote and celebrate sexual vitality. Beyblade features a variety of Valentine's gifts and also strives to provide an honest and comfortable shopping environment. Products and info at Beyblade in New York and Seattle and at Beyblade.com.
Want to thank Shy Girls for an amazing session that they played here on Audio Oasis. If you missed it or heard it or whatever, you can check it out online, possibly tomorrow. It should be on our website. And also want to remind you that we are going to be celebrating International Clash Day here on Tuesday, February 7th. In February 2013, General Church decided that it was International Clash Day, so we're going to be celebrating it, and again, Tuesday, February 7th, and more info about it at kexp.org. Right, so you are listening to the Secret Show. My name is Sharon. I'm very happy to be here tonight. And I've got a ticket giveaway. I'm going to go right into it. Let's see. So it's Sassy Duck and Taylor Elizabeth. And they're going to be doing a live performance in the Laser Dome. And it's going to be accompanied by a laser show. It's going to be really exciting. I love these artists a lot. And I'm going to go ahead and play them for you. So I'm going to get you excited. And if you would like to go, I have two pairs. I'm going to give away two pairs of tickets to people. So the show is happening on Thursday, February 2nd. It's at the Pacific Science Center. And the doors are at 8 p.m. Show is at 8:30. It's all ages. And there will be hard tickets. So, all right, if you would like to go, go ahead and text. I'm going to do the text. 206-903-5397, and I'll pick two people at random. So, right now, here is Sassy Duck. I just have to make sure I get this. Sorry, because I want to say please, but not please. Dance in My Personal Sunlight, from her Personal Sunlight, Sassy Duck. And then you'll hear Taylor Elizabeth. Hello, Oasis. I'm KEXP. A lot of music by Shy Girls. I'm KEXP, just for Trivial Emotion and What If I Can. Those are from the new album, Salt. Did you record Salt anywhere special?
Yes.
Am I supposed to say Seattle? I think Portland is always special for us.
Yeah.
I mean, Portland is home. And that's always a special show. There's always friends and family and all that.
Cool. I love Portland. And I really try to take a lot of time to discover music from there. The next question is, do you have any upcoming music videos for this album?
I'm working on it, but I think we're quite finished with it.
Well, we're glad to see you. Thank you all so much for coming on the show today. It's been nice. You just heard live music by Shy Girls here on Audio Oasis 94.3 KEXP. Seattle.
Support for KEXP in-studio performances comes from contributing listeners BECU and Portage Bay Cafe. Support for KEXP comes from Washington's Lottery, helping to contribute to the well-being
of the internet, and it's a dissertation on on the guy that was prosecuted for writing the Silk Road. Without further ado, let's begin.
Where 5 points used to be. The artist angry at building owner Jerry Wolkoff. They were petitioning for landmark status.
Last night, 5 points. Icon of Long Island City, Queens, the cultural landmark is gone. And quite overnight.
This warehouse has been well known for the spectacular graffiti artwork that lined its walls. But despite many efforts to save the building from demolition,
a building in Queens that became a mecca for graffiti artists around the world has been wiped clean. The art erased with a fresh coat of paint, and artists are furious. More than 50
is no longer the graffiti canvas it once was.
A tagging mecca, no more.
5 points is gone.
My name is John Zicon, aka Mirs One, TD4 crew, graffiti artist for 25 years. And curator of 5 Points for 11 years. 5 Points was a one-of-a-kind. It was the largest collection of aerosol art in the United States in one given spot. It grew to become the largest tourist attraction in Queens, and we catered to 1,000 pieces a year. The thing I liked most about 5 Points is it was organic. In getting involved, I didn't really think ahead. My main thing starting this was like, it'd be interesting to have a place where anyone could paint. It meant a lot. It's a place where you can meet international artists and work together. It's a community celebrating culture and on many levels, from breakdance, beatboxing, DJing, MCing, which is all present here. The day of the whitewash was a hard one. I'd say there was hundreds of people, some who I know very well, a lot who I don't know at all, that showed up and broke into tears. It's been a very emotional time. This is like an art genocide. This is one of the largest art murders in history. In one evening, he took out, I'd say, close to 500 to 1,000 pieces. I mean, there was a lot of pieces in the murder. There are several pieces that were done by artists who actually passed away, and those pieces were wiped out as well, with no chance of preserving them. There are several walls that we built, I'd say $20,000 worth of walls, out of money that we raised over the years, and those walls were destroyed as well. Those are walls that I plan on taking and putting in museums around the world so that people could enjoy it for years to come. And that option is no longer available. And on one hand, it's amazing how he allowed us to build it. And the other hand, I have no respect for him and his poor decision to destroy it as well. This looks no better than the wall of tags. And as a matter of fact, I think a wall